help clean the floor up.
Got you helping. Good. Keep you busy. Welcome back to my channel. So I am headed out to the hair salon. I need to do something about my hair. It doesn't look too terribly bad right now, but it is so thin. I have lost so much hair since Avalee's been born. She's 6 months now and I'm just still losing clumps of it, and it's just driving me crazy. Plus I haven't done anything with it in a long time. It's been about 3 years since I've had anything done to it. I haven't colored it. I haven't had it cut more than like a trim here and there. So I'm like, well, it would be fun to change things up a little bit again, because I have had it shorter and I have had it lighter in the past. So I'm like, well, we'll see. We'll go back to that and see how I like it. Definitely getting it shorter. The losing the hair is just, it's so thin right now. I never wear it down right now because it's just driving me crazy, always losing it. So I'm definitely going shorter, probably like, I think collarbone length, and the lightening it, I think I'm gonna have her lighten it. We'll see. All right. Wow. Let's talk about it different. Why don't we? I love it though. It's really fun. She did a great job with the color. It's been long and dark for the longest time. So this will be a bit of a learning curve, figuring out how to style it and how to wear it. But I'm excited, and it needed it. Oh my goodness. She looked at my hair and she was like, "Hey, you've got this like kind of V going on in the back here," because I had lost so much hair after the baby. So it needed it, and it feels great, and I'm excited, and yeah, it'll be a lot of fun. The rest of this video is probably gonna take place over some different days. We're on vacation, life is nuts. Today I actually got out of the house for the afternoon, but this morning we had a sleepover last night with all the little girl cousins, and this morning like the house was just insane. So that's kind of how life is going right now. So these videos are all kind of just pieced together over different days. I think today this is all I'm gonna be filming, so yeah, it'll be a little random. So I just wanted to show you guys and kind of explain, so I didn't just pop on camera and like, hey, I'm totally different, by the way. All right, it is several days later and today is fair day. So we are at my sister's house, which is a little bit of a construction site. They're working on remodeling their house. So we've got my dad downstairs doing drywall, and all the kids are here, and they've got like stuff stored in their living room and whatnot, which is why it's so cluttered looking, because they're still working on getting stuff together. But we're gonna be, not right now, buddy. That snack life. We're gonna be heading to the fair. I think my sister and I are gonna try to go with Nora and her little girl and like watch some of the grandstand shows with the horses, because the fair here, they do a really, really great job with a lot of the shows. So we're gonna try to like look at some of the pony, you know, little carriage stuff in the grandstands, and then the Clydesdales. And then later tonight we'll go and we'll do all the rides with everybody. So it's gonna be a bit of a nutty day, but it's always a lot of fun. It was a lot of why I wanted to come back in August, was to be able to bring these guys, because they're older and they can go on more rides, and it's a good fair. They do a lot of different things with, you play with the mailbox? You do a lot of different things.
Stayed in our house. We didn't stay in our house.
Yeah, I stayed in this house too. It helps clean the floor. It's like mopping with your feet.
Help Auntie Katie sweep up her floor.
You're gonna stay on the stairs. You can't come down here with Grandpa. So like they're completely, the whole basement was unfinished. So they're working on finishing it. And they've got fireplace back there, and this is going to be a wet bar area and a playroom. You're going to stay right there.
No.
Yeah. Yep. Right up there, because Grandpa's working.
No, they is the house.
Be in the house.
I gotta go get some butt shims.
Every big
Somewhere?
House.
This thing is.
Every big house, Mommy.
Okay, then go in the playhouse.
I gotta get something to shim that up with a little bit.
What's that gonna be back there?
That's just a closet. See, this studs way.
Oh, yeah.
I'll shim it out a little bit.
Mm.
Crappy lumber. Hey there, kid.
Hey, Mommy. So that's what they've been dealing with this past summer. I think they started in May, and they've still got a while. But they're doing like a little under the stairs playhouse for the kids.
Yeah.
I've been in there. I've already been in there. In the bathroom.
No, Mommy.
They did their tiling and stuff. So I'll link their channel below. They have a YouTube channel, and they're just kind of sharing their... We gotta go upstairs. There's no bathroom in here. Yep. And they're just sharing their remodel journey. But a lot of the stuff they're doing themselves. Brian, her husband, did all the tile work in here, and they're, you know, flooring and all that kind of stuff. They're all doing that themselves. And then my dad's a drywall contractor, so that's why he's in here doing all their drywall. But yeah, I'll link their channel in the description. It's called This Is Our Home, and it's a lot of fun seeing it all come together because it's been a lot of work for them. And they started with it just being an empty concrete room, and now we're here, which is exciting. Yeah, Linden's really great. It's a tiny little town, and Katie and Brian live here, so, and they're like two blocks away, so we can just walk, which helps out a lot. We don't have to pay for parking, and we don't have to fight for a parking space.
Why do they make
them? They get them all dressed up for the show, and they show off, so they're fun to watch.
Yeah. 45 years of showing at the Northwest Washington Fair, Edwin Hankins of the Northwest Clydesdale graciously agreed to allow the drill team the opportunity to perform a pattern of music in front of the grandstands right here at the fair instead of pitching his six-horse hitch. The aim for the team is to show the public the willing nature and easygoing personality of the draft horse in any discipline. In any situation. Without people like Trevor, our country wouldn't be the great country that it is today. But up on the wagon seat with Seth is Brandy Mitchell, Ferndale, Washington, Aviation Hospital Corpsman, U.S. Navy and U.S. Marine Corps, deployed in the Mediterranean 1996 and 1997, Persian Gulf in 1998. Yeah! Yeah! You know what? He didn't want to see where he was going, but he sure had a good view of where he was.
He did good.
Prairie City, Oregon, I believe, is a cedar.
How many times did you do mutton busting?
Probably do this at home before breakfast just for fun, don't they?
Twice, yeah. 2 different years. Never here at this fair. It was when we were in Montana. But she did mutton busting twice. Did pretty good.
Yeah.
Well, Chief Barn, where we did all of our showing.
Okay, this way, honey.
We spent a lot of time in these barns.
We're gonna go pet animals.
Look at the babies. They're having a nap.
You serious?
They probably just ate and they're all sleepy now.
Thank you.
time, y'all. One hop this time. One hop this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross.
Yeah, I'm saying out there.
Crisscross. Chop, chop, real smooth.
There she goes.
Let's go to work.
She's like, oh shoot,
Nora's going. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Two hops this time. Two hops this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Hands on your knees, hands on your knees.
You gotta be a big boy tonight and do some walking, all right?
That's fairly low time.
Because the stroller's for the babies.
No boy. No big boys.
That's right. So Uncle Brian is the stand-in for like Nathan tonight, as far as going on the rides, the big rides with Nora, and she's had her eye on this one, the Sea Dragon. She's had her eye on that one all day long, and it's a fun one. I remember we loved this one when we were growing up, so I'm excited to see how she likes it.
They're
getting close to the back, so she's gonna be up there a ways. But it's great. Uncle Brian's being the adult to ride with her tonight, so she'll have fun. All right, so we're still in the middle of the fair, but my phone's about to die, so I need to probably end the video here. We're on our way back. This little guy, he was in like one of those little, I don't know what you call them, you know, fun houses, I guess, the little castle fun house, and he got a little scared, so he wet himself. So another perk that my sister's nearby is just walking him back to change his shorts.
but about to lose my phone. So yeah, I need to end the video here, but we're having a great time. As you can see, it's so much fun to be back. The fair is definitely something that's been a part of our family for decades at this point. I mean, I started coming when I was still tiny, when my older siblings were showing like pigs and rabbits and stuff. So it's a lot of fun to be here and be able to bring my kids. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys had fun, you know, experiencing this with us. Please subscribe if you're new and like the video if you enjoyed it. I'll see you guys with the next one.
One yours?
Pay off.
Yeah.